Hello and welcome to Art Abandonment Adventures. Today is an art creation day. I will be working on the collection, The 12 Days of Christmas, series number 7, Christmas Kittens. This is an assemblage piece in which I will be upcycling different cats and beads that I have purchased at thrift stores. Step number 1, prep the pieces. To prep the pieces, take a disinfectant cloth and just wipe over them. That will remove any handprints or anything that is on them from being at the thrift store. Step number 2, prime the pieces. Since this plastic is material that doesn't normally get painted on, by priming it with the white acrylic paint, you are setting up a surface that will quickly absorb the paint so that you can paint with less amount of layers, and it'll also keep it from peeling. After you prime all the pieces, let the paint dry before moving on to the next step. Step number 3 is paint the base color. When it comes to choosing the paint and the type of paint that you use to paint the figures, that is a custom choice. I'm using brighter colors, and they are an acrylic matte paint. You can choose neons, metallics, you can go with more closely related cat colors. Whatever choice of color that you want, make sure to paint the pieces completely, and with adding that white paint as a primer, it will take on the additional base color much easier. After you completely finish painting the pieces, let the paint dry before moving on to the next step. Step number 4 is customize the pieces. When it comes to customizing the pieces, I will be using two techniques. The first technique is the shape design. For the shape design, you take paint and you make different shapes on the fig. The shapes will vary in both color and size. After I let the shapes dry, I then come back and I'm going to be writing words of encouragement on the cats. The words of encouragement can be any choice of words that you want. Most of these dealt with love and peace and joy and never ever giving up. So just choose whatever words you want to relay in the message, and I'm just using a dotting tool to write straight on the figures. After I customize the pieces just the way I want them, I'll let the paint dry before moving on to the next step. Step number 5 is sign the pieces. The first thing I'm going to do is paint the bottoms of the paws a black paint, and that for me signifies the pieces are finished. Then I'll come back and sign the pieces with my pseudonym, which is TS Art. The signatures will either be on the bottom of the paws or on the bottom of the bodies. I will also put on the date 2019 for the year that I created the pieces. You can decide if you are going to sign or not sign the pieces. It's not a necessity to sign. I do it because of the videos, and I also abandon quite a few pieces in one area at a time, and that way if multiple friends or family find pieces, they'll know it came from the same artist. After you've signed the pieces, let the paint dry before moving on to the next step. Step number 6, clear the pieces. I am using a spreadable clear, then I have also added different sequins and glitter to. There are many different kinds of varnishes or clear available, from spreadable to sprayable. So what you need to do is choose what kind of clear that you're going to use and completely clear the entire piece. After you completely clear all the pieces, let the clear dry before moving on to the next step. Step number 7 is assemble the pieces. I'm using my rotary tool to make a start hole for the eye ring that I'll be placing inside of the figures. Now, if you don't have a rotary tool, you can use a nail and a hammer to make a starter hole. And the big thing is, if you make that starter, it's just a whole lot easier to attach the eye hook. And the eye hook becomes important for what we're going to be doing with the beads. Next, you're going to take crafting wire and wrap it around the neck so that you can make like a collar. Then you want to snip off the length of wire that you need and attach one end to the eye hook. Then I am taking beads that I have gotten at thrift stores and feeding them through the wire and attaching it to the other side of the neck to the same eye hook, and now I have formed a collar out of beads. The pieces are now ready to be abandoned. These are images of the six cats that will be abandoned in this series. If you have liked what you've seen, push the like button, leave a comment, and follow. The following pictures are pieces that have already been abandoned from the collection, The 12 Days of Christmas. I love hearing from those individuals that have found a piece of my art. To share where you found a piece or any special story about a piece, you can send an email to the address on the business card. You can send a comment to the Facebook Art Abandonment group, or you can leave a comment down below. And as always, happy abandoning.